Hey folks, welcome back. In this video, we're going to go over methods of heat transfer, namely conduction, convection, and radiation. So let's get into it. Now, the first thing to realize is that heat can be transferred from one place to another by one of three methods. So this is conduction, convection, and radiation. So we'll look at each of these in more detail. And you should be aware that conduction and convection involve particles, whereas radiation involves electromagnetic waves. So looking at conduction first of all, conduction is the transfer of heat through a solid. So it's all to do with solid objects. Heat flows from a high temperature to a low temperature, and insulators, for example plastics, do not let heat travel through them well, though conductors, for example metals, do. And some typical examples of conduction might involve cooking food in a frying pan, where the contact of the food with the hot frying pan is going to cause the food to cook, clothes drying on a radiator, where you've got the clothes in contact with the hot surface of the radiator, and lastly a cup of tea making the cup itself hot, where the hot liquid within the cup is in contact with the cup and therefore it's going to transfer heat to the cup itself. Next we have convection, and convection is the transfer of heat from one place to another by the movement of fluids. And by fluids we mean liquids and gases. So convection is different to conduction in that convection deals with liquids and gases, whereas conduction deals with solids only. So since heated fluid is less dense than cooler fluid, it rises and the cooler fluid moves down to replace it, creating a circular motion. And this is also known as a convection current. So some examples of where this kind of motion might occur is in convector radiators, boiling water in a pot, blood flow around the human body, and a pond freezing over. All of these things use the idea of convection to transfer heat. Lastly, we have radiation, and you should know that all objects emit and absorb radiation in the form of heat, which is also known as infrared radiation. We say that the hotter an object is, the more infrared radiation it emits. And remember, for radiation, there are no particles involved, so heat can travel through a vacuum, for example space, by radiation. So radiation is all to do with the transfer of heat by waves rather than particles. So some examples of radiation include heat from the sun. So the fact that the heat from the sun travels in waves rather than particles means they can get through the Earth's atmosphere and through space, so they can reach us on Earth. We've also got the human body as an example. So because we are warm-blooded mammals, we're going to emit infrared radiation from our bodies. Now just to summarise, this picture here gives a good example of where all three methods of heat transfer can be applied to the same situation. So imagine you're heating a pot of water on a hob or the cooker, and the pot itself is in contact with the hob. So you'll see that some of the heat is being transferred to the handle, which will travel from hot to cold through this solid handle. And that means if you touch the handle, it might be hot in this case. So this is why the majority of pot handles are not metal, because if that was the case, the heat would travel along very well and you would burn your hand every time you tried to pick up the pot with the handle. So usually the handles will be plastic, as that's a good insulator. So we've got conduction there. We've also got the water inside the pot, which as it heats up at the bottom, that becomes less dense than the cooler water above it, and therefore the hot water is going to rise to the surface and the cooler water will fall down to replace it. So in this way we get a sort of convection current inside the pot until all of the water has reached the same temperature, and at this point we say that the water is said to be in thermal equilibrium. So lastly we've got radiation, where the heat waves from the hob might be emitted in different directions and to the surroundings, and therefore you might lose some heat to the surroundings, making it not very efficient for boiling your pot of water. So there we have conduction, convection, and radiation shown for one specific example. That's all for this video folks, thanks for watching. If you made it to the end, I really appreciate it. Make sure to give the video one of these, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.